this video, we are going to talk about how big Indianapolis is. It's bigger than you think, or maybe it isn't as big as you think. Chances are, it's probably not what you think, so stick around. Hey everybody, I'm Jason Compton. I'm a local real estate agent in the Indy metro area, and this is Living in Indianapolis. So if you want to know everything there is to know about living in Indianapolis, then make sure you subscribe and tap the bell so you're notified every time I do a new video every single week. All right, so in today's video, we're going to talk about how big is Indianapolis. And there are a lot of opinions on this. First, you actually have to get into, well, what defines a big city? How do you do that? You could use hard numbers and compare them from one city to the next. You could also get into really subjective things like what there is to do, what people think. So we're going to talk about a number of those things here in this video today. So first, defining a big city using hard numbers. What do we usually use? We can use a bunch of different things, but let's say we're using how large or how spread out the city. How much land does the city actually take up? So Indianapolis, it's about 372 square miles. And you might be thinking, who cares? I have no idea what that means. And most people, they're not going to. I don't know what that means. 372 square miles, how big is that? It sounds huge, but is it? I don't really know. So if we took Indianapolis on a map and just made it into a perfect square or rectangle, let's just call it a square for simplicity's sake, it'd be about 19.3 miles across and 19.3 miles in the other direction. So that comes out to about 372 square miles or so. Now, Indianapolis, it's definitely not a perfect rectangle or perfect square, although it's kind of similar to a square, especially when you take a look at I-465, which encircles the city. Generally, most people here in Indianapolis, in the area, we think everything inside the loop, we call it the loop, is Indianapolis. At least you would have an Indianapolis address. There are a few exceptions, like with Lawrence, also Speedway, Indiana, where the Indianapolis Motor Speedway is, or Beech Grove, places like that, exceptions. And then, of course, Indianapolis, your address, living in Indianapolis, might squeak outside of 465 just a little bit. But generally, we're talking 372 square miles or so, 19.3, 20 miles or so to get across town. So thinking about that as far as drive time is concerned, how long is it going to take you to get from one side of town to the other? You know, if it's roughly 20 miles and you're going 20 miles an hour, it's going to take you an hour. But if you're going 60 miles an hour, which is probably a little bit more reasonable, it might take you 20 minutes. Now, is it really going to take you 20 minutes to get all the way across Indianapolis? No, it's not. No, not a chance. Well, if you're trying to get across town, you're probably going to have to take 465, or you're going to have to cut through town in some way via a road or something like a highway, like I-70. And it's going to take you a lot longer. Generally, it takes to get from one side of the town to the other in Indianapolis, depending on traffic. It could take you 30 minutes. It could take you an hour. Sometimes it might take somewhere in between that, of course, or even a little bit longer. It just depends on so many factors. So Indianapolis, when you're looking at the square mileage, how much space it actually takes up, Indianapolis is pretty spread out. It's actually the ninth largest city when you're talking about how much land it actually takes up. There's only eight cities that are larger than Indianapolis. So let's take a look at the list. What are those eight cities? If we look at the list here, we've got San Antonio, Texas, certainly bigger, Los Angeles, California, Nashville, Phoenix, Oklahoma City, Houston, Jacksonville, and Anchorage. Anchorage, Alaska is ridiculous. It is by far and away the largest city in the country as far as how much space it takes up. But we don't consider Anchorage a big city. It has less than 300,000 people. Just because it takes up a huge area, by most people's definition, it's not a big city. So just looking at exactly what that is, the square mileage, it's pretty safe to say that most people don't define a big city by how much space it takes up. But it does have a bit of a factor in the feel of that city for sure, which we'll talk about. Now, the hard numbers that we usually use to define a big city is, I think, obviously population. How many people live there? And this, I think, can be a little bit surprising to a lot of people. Indianapolis ranks 17th in the country, in the United States, as far as the population is concerned. So 16 other cities are certainly larger than Indianapolis. And I think some of them come as no surprise at all. Cities like New York, Los Angeles, Chicago, Houston, Phoenix, these are all obviously huge cities, gigantic cities. Now, when you get outside of Indianapolis and you start to include all of the Indianapolis metropolitan area, so a lot of the suburbs, the big suburbs like Fishers, Carmel, Westfield, Noblesville, Greenwood, Avon, Plainfield, goes on and on and on. The population around here gets up close to 2 million people or so, a little bit over 2 million people. And that actually drops the population of Indianapolis or the ranking of Indianapolis in the country down if you take other cities and start to include their metropolitan areas as well. And I think Indy ranks around 34th in the country when you start to put those numbers in there. Now, here is where we can take some of those numbers and some subjectivity can start to arise from them. If we take a look at a stat called population density, so taking a look just at some of the largest cities in the country, like New York City, Los Angeles, Chicago, the number of people per square mile, New York, 28,000 people per square mile. No wonder it feels like everybody's living on top of one another in New York. But we get down to some of these other cities, like Jacksonville and Indianapolis, which are certainly top 20 cities in the country as far as their population is concerned, and we look at their density, much, much lower. Just not very dense at all. And actually, Jacksonville, out of the top 20 most populated cities in the United States, Jacksonville is the only one that is less dense than Indianapolis. But Jacksonville covers over 700 square miles. You compare that to Indianapolis at 372 square miles. Jacksonville is twice as large as Indianapolis in the amount of land that it covers. The other cities in that top 20, they're all more dense than Indianapolis. So that can give them a more populated feel and a larger feel. And I think that plays tricks on people in Indianapolis, or at least it leads to a misconception that Indianapolis is not as big as what you think. It's just not that dense here. And that might be a good thing for you. So if you're thinking about moving to Indianapolis, or even if you already live, you're currently living in Indianapolis, well, Indianapolis is just not that dense. It's still a big city, but doesn't have that big city feel. So if you live in California, if you're watching this video somewhere there, if you're watching it in Florida or a place like Houston, which is certainly a big city, whatever your perception is about Indianapolis, it's highly populated, but not very dense. And it can lead to misconceptions for people who don't live here, but also people who do live here. This is very interesting. My own wife, when she has grown up in Indianapolis and lived here all her life, but when we travel and we go to other states, and I even have other friends and other family members who will say this exact same thing. So when people ask us where we're from, if we're in other states, they will say Indiana. They will not say Indianapolis. And I think it's because they aren't sure if people have heard of Indianapolis, or they think it's such a small town that it may be just out of their mind completely. And myself, I have a picture of thinking that Indianapolis is larger, and I'll chime in and say, we're from Indianapolis. I think people know where Indianapolis is. Even people outside of the country know where Indianapolis is. And there are several things that might attribute to that, especially the Indy 500. That's an international event. So it's the biggest sporting event in the world, and it happens right here in Indianapolis. So that's one of the things that can contribute to Indianapolis being known. But I just find that fairly funny that you have this large city and people who even live here don't really consider it a large city. It's definitely known as the biggest small city or biggest small town that you will ever experience. And I think that that density has a little bit to do with that. Plus the Midwestern vibe that we have, certainly one of the pros of living in Indianapolis, and just how friendly people are and how outgoing people are and just willing to help one another. You may not have that so much in a huge city. You're a little bit more faceless. Indianapolis, not so much. So there you have it. Indianapolis, is it a big city? Well, by the numbers, yeah, it's a big city. It's one of the biggest cities in the country. But subjectively, maybe not. You know, always you have these perceptions about what's big, what's not. I caught this fish and it was this big. Well, in reality, it might be this big. So there you have it. Indianapolis, how big is it? Well, we went through some numbers so you can get an idea. And if you have any questions about whether the size of Indianapolis or the feel of Indianapolis is right for you, feel free to call me, text me, email me, and I'm happy to walk you through any kind of questions that you have and hopefully answer those for you. Until the next video, take care. We'll see you later.